Hello, hello, hello. We're back, honey. Here we are. I'd like to say just a couple things about what do you think of when you think of the word legacy? What do you think of when you think of that word? And that's an important word. When we think of legacy, many times, most times we think of money, possessions, property, leaving that to someone that's dear to us. But I want to talk to you about something much more important. That's a spiritual legacy. The author of salvation is in you and in me, and he is developing a relationship. And he calls us, and as I was looking in Deuteronomy chapter 6, speaking to Moses, Moses says, you as parents, fathers and mothers, pass on a legacy, a spiritual legacy to your children, children's children. It speaks to us, to our friends, co-workers, those all around us.
I think that is so much more important than, you know, other kinds of legacy, like you're saying, financial. It's nice to leave
which
things
we want to.
You do.
The best of our ability, yes.
But leaving a good name behind you.
Oh, yes.
Leaving the heritage of the Lord
behind you
is so important.
You know, it's so true. Yeah. Christianity is only one generation away from extinction. Yeah. And so it's up to us. And Moses says, do it in your homes, first of all, first and foremost. As you go out with your friends, co-workers, when you're lying down, when you're asleep, the first thing when you wake up in the morning, develop this relationship so we can pass Jesus on. And that's our mission. And Jonathan and Jennifer, our children's family pastor, life pastor, this Sunday's his last Sunday. He has helped parents do that.
He has. He's done a fantastic job.
A great job in a great way. And so we want you to bless them. So this Sunday, we're going to have a card basket here in the lobby. Give them a card. Write something. Appreciate them. Put something monetarily in there. Bless them. A big God bless you.
Yeah. We're going to have cake. And you know what Jonathan mentioned? Those words of affirmation mean a lot to him. Something that he'll hang on to and read. And that's important, you know.
It's very important.
And in times of discouragement, you know,
Which happens.
Something good to go back to.
Amen.
And you get to read, you know what,
amen.
I did make a difference.
Amen.
And, you know, we want
very
to do
much
that
so.
For him. We want to bless him. So
yes, we do.
Come ready.
And then we're praying for the next to come. Those to come that's going to take this ministry position, how important it is. Yes. It's so important to us. We're praying. We're talking to several people. So we want to pass on Jesus Christ to the next generation in this community.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Remember the events that are coming out. I'm sure they'll be on the screen on Sunday. Light Up the Night, Trunk or Treat. That's coming up in both campuses. So you will want to get ready. Please volunteer to help to set up
your
trunk.
It's going to take all of us to make this happen.
It's going to take everybody to do everything again. It's just 2 nights that we're doing it, one at each location, but please take, pick it up and do your part for it so we can bless our community. It's just a touch to bless our community.
That's right.
Ladies, you can still sign up for the event in November, and it's going to be great.
Yes,
I hope that you do sign up. We already have 60-plus women attending with us.
Oh, that's great.
So
that really is.
I think everyone is ready to get away and do that.
Yep. Jesus is real. Jesus is alive. He's on the move, and we want to be part of everything that he's doing.
Amen. Don't be discouraged.
That's it. Jesus Christ is Lord. See you this Sunday.